This brief video is focused on getting a useful code system built inside of Dedoose. Codes are essentially the conceptual framework that you will use to organize, understand, and communicate the findings of your research. You can think of it as being an outline for how you're going to organize information. Adding a code to Dedoose is a simple process. Simply enter editing mode, click on the plus sign if we want to add a root code. New code, you can provide a description of what it is. We can also enable a tag weighting system. We'll leave this one set with a scale from 0 to 10. I'm going to submit that to the system. Your code system inside of Dedoose can be a simple list, or it can be organized in a hierarchical fashion. For example, we have a code here on reading by mother, in a study we did collecting interviews about reading practices at home. So for example, we decided that duration was actually a child code to the reading by mothers. In editing mode, I can simply drag it and drop it onto its parent, frequency as well. So what this particular system would do is help us code those excerpts that were related to reading practices by mother, but also specific information related to the duration of a reading episode and how frequently. So here's a good place to say something about the weight system. You can see here that the reading by mother code has a 1 to 5 rating. We use this particular scale to rate the quality of reading practices in the home. For the duration code, however, we used a weight scale of 0 to 90 so that we could indicate in terms of minutes how long reading episodes typically took place. And for frequency, we used a weight scale of 0 to 7 so that we could code for the average days in a week that reading took place by mother in this home. So weight systems can be used to indicate levels of sentiment, importance, or any other dimension that can be overlaid when codes are attached to excerpts. So you can see that by expanding the tree vertically and horizontally, a complex outline or code system can be developed inside of Dedoose. And when we get to the sections on analysis, you'll see how powerful this can be. Also, an alternative to creating child tags, besides dragging and dropping codes on top of each other, is to go into the tag itself and then click on Add Child Tag. This accomplishes the same thing. Finally, you can see that in editing mode, when floating over particular codes, two arrows appear. These allow us to alter the ordering that codes are presented. So we can click on that and move reading by others up the tree. So there are basically two orders of presentation for codes inside of Dedoose. If we exit editing mode, we can see here that we have a custom ordering, or by clicking here, we can toggle between a custom and alphabetical display. One other tip that we find very useful is that it's always useful to have a code labeled great quotes or some other label that can be used as a shortcut to quickly go to those excerpts that really capture the types of information you're trying to communicate. Since you can use any number of codes on a particular excerpt, when we see the content that really brings it home for us, we also apply the great quotes code. And finally, you'll see on our videos on excerpting and analysis of how a hierarchical code system can be applied and used for efficient and effective analysis.